What's good, YouTube? Welcome to Trendy Topics, where we discuss the latest in hip-hop and gossip. In today's video, we want to talk about WAC 100 disrespecting 6ix9ine, Birdman offers to pay rent for an entire community, and Lil Xan rushed to hospital after having a panic attack. So the first topic we're going to talk about is that boy WAC 100 disrespecting 6ix9ine. Now, y'all know that boy 6ix9ine been feeling the heat ever since he's been released from prison. We see where 6ix9ine even posted a clip on Instagram, and then he deleted it. For some reason, I think that he was getting a lot of hate. That's why he deleted it. But WAC 100, he said F 6ix9ine the other day. And then now a lot of persons wanted to know why he said that. Now, WAC 100 also explained that he doesn't hate 6ix9ine, but he just doesn't respect what he did. Also, he's blaming it on some of the alleged gang members, saying that they're so desperate for money that they're willing to let an uptown type of person get in their crew. And then now they all end up behind bars because he ratted out and stuff. WAC 100 is a person that he just speaks how he feels, which definitely can have a good impact or a bad impact, because we see where he disrespected Tupac in the past and he came on a lot of backlash because of that. But enough of me rambling. Now I'm gonna play the live so y'all can hear what WAC 100 have to say, and y'all can let me know if you agree or if you disagree. Now check this out.
I've been hearing a lot of chat about 6ix9ine. Know what I'm saying? Nigga home. And I think he cooking right now. 6ix9ine is gonna show y'all what the industry is all about. Y'all gonna learn something about this shit. Hey, the point about me saying fuck 6ix9ine, because me personally, I ain't got nothing against him. I don't give a fuck about whatever his situation is. The way I see it, personally, you know, in my life, in my world, I don't allow people into our jungle like that. You know, so do I blame him for his actions? Partially, mainly because, you know, he did what I told y'all he would do. You know, the streets done got so bad and so motherfucking desperate. A nigga wave a little money in front of a motherfucker and they forget about 20, 30, 40 years of politicking that it took for your neighborhood to be what it is. I mean, you know, I honestly feel like the kid knew too much information. If he was a rapper, it should have been studio, video, venue. That's it.
So, yeah, guys, that is what WAC 100 have to say. I mean, we all know WAC is a person, as I say, just speak how he feels. And I'm pretty sure that WAC 100 is a part of the Blood Gang. And we all know that he's the manager for Blueface, and Blueface is Crip. So, I mean, it is what it is, guys. But let me know how y'all feel about this. So now I want to talk about Birdman, man. I see Birdman doing some big shit out here. Definitely got to salute him. Now, this story comes from a website that is called The Blast. So it says, Birdman offers to pay next month rent for an entire neighborhood in New Orleans. Hip-hop mogul Birdman has just made an incredibly generous offer to help people suffering during the unemployment in his hometown of New Orleans. The Cash Money Records boss has just offered to pay the month of May's rent for an entire neighborhood near where he grew up in Uptown New Orleans. Birdman took to Instagram to announce the shocking gift, and in his post, he was very specific about where exactly he wanted to spend his money. I would like to offer to pay rent for everybody of the month of May for those who are in need in residence area of Uptown New Orleans, where I was born and raised, at MacMelf Callio and St. Thomas Housing, also from 3rd Ward to 17th Ward, he began. So I definitely got to salute Birdman for doing stuff like this. He's definitely showing that he has a heart. And we see with this COVID-19 pandemic, a lot of persons are getting laid off. A lot of persons, you know, they can't afford to pay their rent. So even if it's just for 1 month, I think that will help out a lot of persons. But what do y'all think about Birdman reaching out to help persons to pay their rent and stuff? Definitely got to salute him. And also, guys, we want to talk about Lil Xan real quick. So Lil Xan was rushed to the hospital because he had a pandemic-induced panic attack. Now, what that means is that Lil Xan, he's feeling a bit overwhelmed because he has to stay home and not go on the road and stuff like that. So I'm not sure if this triggered some form of nerves, and that's the reason why they had to rush him to the hospital. And this story is coming from TMZ, so I'm pretty sure, you know, this is accurate. But it is what it is, guys. Lil Xan just have to understand that he can't go outside like he used to. You know, a lot of persons who, I should say, love being on the outdoors, they're being cooperative and being understanding. So hopefully this is the real reason why he ended up being rushed to the hospital and he's not over there doing any, you know, doing some drugs or something like that. But what do y'all think about Lil Xan catching a panic attack? Man, I hope he's okay. I mean, dude seem kind of all right. You know, he's kind of a weirdish fellow, but, you know, he's all right in my books. But leave y'all comments and let me know how y'all feel. Also, guys, remember to hit the thumbs up button if you enjoyed this content. If you don't, you can always hit the thumbs down button. And make sure you subscribe to the channel if you have not yet subscribed. Also, turn on the notification bell to get notified whenever I post new content. Anyway, guys, I'll see y'all in the next video. Stay safe. I'm out. Peace.